Rattlers is a 1976 snakesploitation thriller produced, directed, and co-written by John McCauley, starring Sam Chu, Elizabeth Chaucer, and Dan Priest. On the outskirts of the Mojave Desert, the native rattlesnakes have started to kill people in uncharacteristic ways. These usually solitary creatures are attacking people viciously, unprovoked, and most alarmingly in groups. An expert in herpetology is recruited to investigate these attacks, and paired with a young photographer. They follow the trail to an army base and discover a secret that could threaten the world. Rattlers fits in the nature run-amuck subgenre of horror. Man has tampered in God's domain, and nature responds with great vengeance and furious anger. And snakesploitation is a particularly popular subcategory. Given that snakes are the number two most common fear in the world, Hollywood loves to cast them as an imminent threat. But as many times as the movies have invoked snakes to keep you on the edge of your seat, Rattlers may be the movie most qualified to make you paranoid about snakes. But to get to the snakes, you have to put up with the humans. The scientist and photographer leads are pretty tedious, and when they do try to have character moments, it's awkward. There's a script-mandated romantic subplot that comes out of nowhere, but wraps up almost as quick. None of the characters are particularly interesting or funny, which is usually a fatal flaw for movies like this. The characters that stick with you the most are the ones that die before they have a chance to bore you. And the story's pretty bare bones, although the folks at Cinematic Titanic got enough jokes out of it for an episode. The explanation for the snake aggression comes so late in the movie that it feels a bit like a hand wave. The ending feels rushed and unresolved, and doesn't have as many rattlesnakes in the finale as you might want. There's no gore work, no real special effects. A lady takes a bath around minute 32, and that's it for nudity, so not much for the sickos. What we do get are snake attacks. At least 8 victims on screen. And we don't see any fangs on bodies action. Instead, it's sharp editing and sheer numbers that communicate the shock and terror. In the first 5 minutes, 2 kids fall to their death into a pit of rattlers. The snakes attack people on the road, in their beds, in bathtubs. And perhaps the best scene? The rattlers invade a farm, kill the entire family, and burn down their barn. And again, no special effects here. No sock puppet monsters, rubber serpents, no CGI to declare itself an illusion. Just real snakes. Lots of snakes. 70 snakes on set at one time. And the underdirected film means there's a minimum of dramatic flourishes to telegraph when and where the scares are going to be. Somebody turns a corner and there they are. By the midway point, when the photographer starts seeing snakes everywhere, you understand. This movie works when it taps into the very real fear of being trapped with snakes. The scientist is played by Sam Chu. He had a recurring role on The Bionic Woman around the same time of the film's release. More recently, he switched predators, providing voiceover work for Discovery Channel's Shark Week. Dan Priest plays the Army base commander. He also played the mayor in the TV movie Moon of the Wolf. Celia Kay has one of the most memorable snake encounters in the film. According to her, she was paid $300 for the one-day bathtub shoot and only got bit once. A far cry from her award-winning role in 1964's Island of the Blue Dolphins. Years after Rattlers, she would make an uncredited appearance in Conan the Barbarian, directed by her then-husband John Milius. Irving Goodenough was cinematographer for Rattlers. He'd give snakes the close-up again in the 1978 horror film Jennifer, a Carrie knockoff about a teenage girl who controls snakes with her mind. Besides his cinematography work, Goodenough was a director of many music videos of the I Want My MTV era. In an interview for the book It Came From the 80s, Rattlers director John McCauley admitted the screenplay he wrote was, quote, pretty awful. But it was an attempt for him to move up in his filmmaking career after years of painting houses, shooting commercials, and loading cameras for adult films. Rattlers was his first script to get financial backing, thanks to film producer Harry Novak, who was looking for product he could sell in the B-movie market. Rattlers was cheap enough to be profitable and provided more opportunities for McCauley to pitch projects over the next decade. McCauley would finally direct his second feature in 1985, a slasher film called Deadly Intruder, starring Danny Bonaducci. His third film failed to release in North America, and McCauley retired from filmmaking shortly after that. Rattlers knows what you came to see. It may not try to deliver anything else, but it does deliver what it advertises. Snake attacks, the kind that are easy to imagine and hard to predict, and the diminished stagecraft actually augments the fear. If you want to test your susceptibility for ophidiophobia or test someone else's fear of snakes, this movie might be your particular poison.